In this chapter, we're going to describe the menus on the handwheels when a stabilized V-head is connected. The first thing I'm going to do is go to Settings, Screen, Night Mode On. I'm just doing this in order to be able to see the screen on the camera while I explain all the menus. When the handwheel starts, the first thing it's going to try is to communicate with the head. It won't find the head either if the communication cable is not connected, the standby button on the head is pressed, or the head is switched off. When the head is started, it's going to calibrate. We need to wait until it finishes its calibration, and then it will identify all the axes connected to the handwheels. It will find at least pangyro, roll, and tilgyro. And in this case, we have a Scorpio Focus connected. Now, this is the main screen. We see Scorpio Stabilized Head B on top of it, handwheels, pan, tilt, and roll axis, and a handwheel mark on top of the roll. That means that it has detected the wrong handwheel. We see the maximum speeds of each axis. This is 100% speed. And just under the maximum value, it's another value of speed, which is the actual speed of the head. With the knob, we adjust the speed of each axis independently. Pan, tilt, and roll. And with the reverse button, if it's pressed once, it disengages the axis. If we press it twice, it reverses the polarity, which means it will go in the opposite direction. The tilt degrees and the roll degrees are absolute, which means that the zero is level, with the tilt flat and the roll at level. The pan degrees will depend on where the head has been started. There is another way to display this information by holding the middle of the screen. There is access to the graphic representation of these degrees. To come back to the normal representation, just hold the middle of the screen again, and it's displayed back. When the head starts, it starts with the stabilization off. That means that the magnetic motors moves freely. If we activate the pan, tilt, and roll to on, the stabilization activates, and it stabilizes the camera package automatically. Let's make a walk through the menus. The standby button, once pressed, the motors are disengaged and all the axes of the head can be freely moved. If connect is pressed again, the head engages. It's the same as if the standby button is pressed. Anytime the camera package needs to be modified, the standby button needs to be pressed in order to see if the head is not properly balanced. If the standby button is pressed again, the head engages and it's not possible to move it from the outside. There's still the possibility to move the camera package if we grab the magnetic motors. This is a safety in case something is hit with the camera. It won't break, it will just displace the camera on space. Going to the menu, the first thing we see is the zero position. The zero position is gonna set a zero position for the pan axis. When we press it, it asks to reset all the axis positions. We press OK. And the pan axis now it's at 0 degrees. The tilt and the roll are absolute and as respect the horizon. In the limits menu, we see limits for the head or for the fifth. Inside the head, we see pan, tilt, and roll axis. We select which axis we want to limit. We move that axis to one point, we press set. We move that axis to another point, we press set again, and the bracket closes. Now the head is limited between those two points. These limits are just for safety. It won't work for the shot unless the operator keeps spinning the wheel all the time. Let's see it on the pan axis. We select the pan axis. We press set in this point. We move the head to another point in that axis. We press set. and the head is limited between those two points. To clear that axis, we press clear, and to clear all of them, we press clear all. Let's see now the fifth limits. Here we have the three motors, focus, iris and zoom, and they can be limited exactly as on the head. We select which motor we want to limit, we press set in one point, we move the motor to the other and we press set again. To limit another motor, we select which motor we want to limit, we press set, we move that motor to another point and press set again. To clear the flashed one, we press clear. To clear all of them, we press clear all. In settings, we have the damping. What's the damping? The damping is the stopping ramp of the head on all the axes. What does that mean? A hard damping, it's gonna make more sudden stops. It can be softened up to 100. And the stops on the head will be smoothly. The adjustments of this value will depend on the operator's preferences. By factory, the default value is 10. In the fifth setup can be configured different settings for the fifth motors, such as internal or external control. Internal means it can be controlled by the CCU, the hand wheels. If the camera is internal, the camera run can be started by the touchscreen. If it's external, there is no control in the touchscreen to the camera run. It's the same for the rest of the motors. To control those motors internally, a hand command must be connected on the rear part of the hand wheels. This hand command will have a rocker to control the zoom with the speed of the rocker and a potentiometer on the side to control either the focus or the iris. Depending on where it's connected, it will be assigned automatically to one or the other. And then the motors can be assigned internally. The arrows will reverse the direction of the motors. The reset will recalibrate each motor. It needs to be done in case a lens change. The speed of the motor cannot be controlled because we have a hand unit connected. The mode will allow us to change between Scorpio focus, or Scorpio lens. If we press inside, we'll have access to different menus depending on which digital lens is connected. Zoom compensator. The zoom compensator is going to adjust the speed of the head depending on the position of the zoom motor. To be able to use it, the zoom motor needs to be assigned internally. In case there is no command connected, there will be no access to this menu. So it needs to be internal and a hand command needs to be connected. To activate it, change the state from disabled to enabled. Once enabled, depending on the position of the zoom, the speed of the head will be reduced. We're moving the head at max speed, we tight the lens on the zoom, and the speed is automatically reduced. This can be used to change from wide shots to tight shots in the same take. It's possible to adjust this speed reduction with the mean speed parameter. It can go to 1% of the maximum speed to 100%. The reverse button will be used in case the motor is mounted on the opposite side. Visually, we will see that when the lens is wide, the speed of the head is reduced, and when it's tight, it's fast. The zoom range. The zoom range copies the marks on the lens and introduces them into the system. It will display that information on the screen. To use it, move the motor to one focal mark and press add point. In case you make a mistake with the keypad, you can introduce the mark again. Let's say that this is wrong. With the arrow, you will clear point per point, and with the C, you will erase completely the mark. So let's mark it properly. To 50, we go to the other point and we introduce the 25. Just with two marks, it let us activate the system. It won't be accurate because not all the marks are introduced. We will see that it will interpolate between those two marks and it might not match the marks on the lens. Let's introduce another one. 50, and we will see that on those three marks it's accurate. Between those marks it will interpolate. The information is displayed in here. To clear one point, just move the zoom motor until the current point is the one that you want to erase and press delete point. To clear all the points, press clear points. The focus range. The focus range copies the focal marks on the lens and introduces them into the system. To use it, move the focus motor to one mark, let's say infinity, and introduce that mark. Now move the motor to another position and introduce it. Those two positions will be precise. In between, it will interpolate as before. Once you have set enough marks, enable, and we will see that it goes from infinite to the shortest mark. This information is shown in the main screen. To clear any mark, move the focus motor until the current point is that mark and press delete point. To clear all, clear points. If we press the arrow down, we have access to the command assignment. In this menu, there are the different axes that can be controlled and the different commands that can be used to control those axes. Right now, the pan axis is controlled with the pan handwheel, tilt, tilt handwheel, roll handwheel, and two motors assigning to the hand command. To change it, press on the command, and now the tilt handwheel will control both axes, pan and tilt. To assign the pan handwheel to the tilt axis, just do as shown. Now pan and tilt are reversed. The numbers beside the command indicates that that axis is moving. The default button sets everything to factory settings. Roll mode. There's two roll modes, steer or angle. Steer means that the roll controller marks the position of the roll. You can move the hand wheel to one point and the head will remain in that point. The angle means that anytime the roll axis is moved, it will come back to the center point. With the roll damping, we can adjust how fast is that comeback. If it's harder, it will be more violent. If it's soft, it will be slow. The range is from 1 to 40. With the roll max, we adjust the maximum degrees that we are allowing to the roll to reach. It can go from 1 to 40, 20 per side. The default button, once pressed, sets everything to factory settings. The roll mode in steer, and inside the angle, roll damping at 25 and max at 30. The vibrator generator is a function that can be used to simulate vibrations arriving to the head on each axis independently. If we activate just the pan axis, we will have a vibration on the pan axis. This vibration can be adjusted in gain and frequency. The bigger the gain, the wider it's gonna be this vibration. The lower the gain, the smaller. The frequency can be adjusted too. The bigger the frequency, the faster the vibration. The smaller the frequency, lower vibrations. This function can be used to simulate different kind of effects arriving to the camera, such as earthquakes, the waves of the sea, handheld movement. The axis can be activated independently or the three of them together. If the zoom compensation is activated, that will affect to the vibration generated. The wider, the bigger. The auto standby. The auto standby enables the head to go to standby after a timeout of 5 minutes. If it's enabled, we can adjust the timeout after which the head will go to standby. Default is 5 and disabled. The units. In this menu, we can adjust how to see the units of the focal marks, metric or imperial. Screen. In here, different adjustments of the touchscreen can be done. The brightness can be reduced, or the bright minimum button can be pressed, and even it can be lower the brightness from here. The bright max, it will bring back to the maximum brightness of the touchscreen. The night mode, it's either white on top of black, and the normal is black in top of white. The auto lock, once enabled and after a timeout set of 10 seconds now, the touchscreen will be locked. On the bottom right corner, it will be displayed the locked functions. To unlock, just press yes. The default is disabled. Shortcuts. In the main screen, there could be displayed several shortcuts, such as head limits, feed settings, zoom compensation, vibration generation, zero position, damping, brightness minimum, brightness maximum, and that's it. To use it, choose which menu you want to display on the main screen. In this case, damping. Now in the main screen, damping appears, and if pressed, there's straight access to the damping menu. Another shortcut that can be used is vibration generator. This will be useful to activate the three axes at the same time. It is important to have different frequencies on each axis, otherwise the vibration generated it will be a little bit strange. The default button sets everything to factory, which is disabled. The auxiliary menu is mainly used for troubleshooting. The first thing we see is bus connections. In this menu, we see everything connected to the CCU through the communication bus. We see the software version of the control, and from here we see PanGyro, Roll, TiltGyro with the respective software versions. It's also displayed for Focus Servo, and if any of this is pressed, it gives more information about the software. Last is the hand unit marked with a dot, indicating that it's connected. The next is the command adjustment. In the command adjustment can be adjusted any command connected to the head. To change the command, press on the top on the name. Down the name we see limits and some numbers on the right. The limits is the digital reading of the controller. When the handwheel is moved, it has an actual reading of the controller. The number on the right is the maximum value expected by the system. This maximum value can be adjusted. If the limit button is pressed, when you move the wheel, it's gonna set the speed of the wheel to the maximum speed expected by the system. Now the numbers on the right are 0-2, and it's easier for the operator to reach the maximum speed of the head. It can be used backwards. The wheel can be spinned at really high speed, making it harder for the operator to reach the 100% speed. The default button sets everything to the factory settings. The sensitivity adjusts the relation between the controller and the axis controlled. Sensitivity of 5 is a linear relationship, which means the number of turns on the controller are the same amount of degrees on the head, all the time. The relation is linear. The sensitivity can be reduced to change the relation into more exponential ratios, which will mean the slower the hand wheel will be moved, the slower the head will be moved, but at the end both will have the same maximum speed. These two adjustments can be combined to make the operator feel more comfortable depending on the shot. Again, the default button sets everything to default. If there is a hand command connected, the command and chat screen is slightly different. It appears the JDR pod and the JDR rocker. This is the rocker. The adjustment of this potentiometer will be affected by the position of this knob. To calibrate this rocker, you need to press limit and move the rocker on both sides. That will be the range expected by the system. Remember to always do it with the speed at 100%. The sensibility is the same as on the hand wheels. It changes the relationship between the controller and the axis from linear, which is 5, to more exponential relations. The window is the dead band. It's the range where you press it and it doesn't move. If the window is too small, it might happen that the axis drift. That means that it's moving by itself. If the window is open too much, there will be too much air gap on the rocker. This is what we call the death band. The default sets everything to factory settings. There is another adjustment, which is the pot. The range of this potentiometer is limited. To assign the range of this potentiometer to the system, press limit, move the potentiometer to both limits, and press OK. Now the potentiometer has been adjusted. Alarms. No alarms detected. If any alarm is detected, it will be displayed here. This is a list of the main alarms that can be shown and how to react. There's a temperature protection that can be turned off. The only reason to switch it off is because the temperature sensor is failing. The temperature of each magnetic motor is displayed in here, and the range of working, it can go up to 50-55 degrees. This is the ADC's menus, which displays the digital reading of all the potentiometers connected to the system. The encoder menu displays all the encoders connected to the CCU, just to see if there is reading. TTL indicates the digital inputs into the system. Also indicates if the SD card is detected. The default configuration allows the user to reset all the control user settings, such as dampings, command assignments, vibrations, all the user settings. The memories is used to reset memories, with memories recorded on the head, and the head servo settings is just for laboratory uses. Mm-hmm.